Hello everyone, I'm Alessandra, and today I want to welcome you to the third episode of People Also Ask and We Answer, the interview series of Clearbox AI. Today we will talk about how to harness the power of AI in companies, what it means for companies to introduce, to integrate AI in their processes, and how can take advantage from its power. So we're going to explore this topic with our guests, Shalini Kurapati, CEO and co-founder of Clearbox AI. Hello, Shalini. How are you?
Hi, Alessandra. Great to be here again.
And Marina Geymonat, Head of Innovation Lab at Sisal and AI Expert for Italian Ministry of Economic Development. Hello, Marina.
Thank you. It's a pleasure being here.
Okay, perfect. So, Marina, maybe you would like to introduce yourself a bit, to tell us who you are, what you do.
I'm Marina Geymonat, and I currently work in Sisal in the Innovation Lab, which is a brand new lab created in order to foster innovation in the company. I have very recently joined Sisal, and I've been working before like almost 30 years in Telecom Italia, and particularly in the innovation department. And lately, in the last 10 years, on data analytics, and especially on artificial intelligence. I'm an information scientist. Mm-hmm. And I've made a lot of experience in trying to actually use artificial intelligence in the company to solve real problems. So to really put the AI solutions together with people in the operations and in order to get the most out of it.
Oh, that's great. Actually, that's perfect for our topic today, given your background and everything. So, as you know, our format works on the most researched question on Google on a specific topic. So today we're going to introduce this topic with you, Marina, if you'd like to start. And I would like to ask you, why is artificial intelligence important to business?
Based on my experience, I think that there are at least three directions in which AI can help businesses. The first context in which I see usefulness of AI is probably the simplest, and is where you can use very simple AI algorithms that can help taking simple decisions which are not so critical and that human take with no neurons almost, but they have to do it. So it goes strictly coupled with automation. There is another way that AI can help, and this is a little bit more difficult, and is doing things that humans are not able to do. That especially when we talk about companies that have a huge amount of data, and no human could ever make any good decision, even less in real time, but also every quarter of an hour, by looking at millions of different, very small data that make no sense to a human person. So what we do now is helping people with a very smart visualization so that they can catch immediately what's happening and make the right decision. But here is where AI really comes into play. Because if you can automate in AI algorithm the understanding of what's going on in this very huge amount of data, complex amount of data, and explain to humans what's going on so that human can take the right decision, or embed in the AI algorithm the decision to take, that would help a lot to achieve a much better operation, a much better decision. Another example is very based on visual search. So we talk about a kind of anomaly detection that can be done, typically is done by visual search, visual analysis, can also be done by checking amount of data to verify if there are anomalies. And this is where also AI can help a lot. So you can check and verify a lot of products, animals, people, whatever, and verify that everything is going well or if there is something wrong. And last, the one where you use speech recognition. So in that case, you can make a lot of support to people. So customer care is one of the most used context where this is can be applied, and you understand what's the customer problem or question, and you directly automate it with solving the problem or getting to answer the question with real data taken from the real world.
That's a great overview. Thank you, Marina. And of course, we're talking also about optimizing processes in company with AI. So Shalini, I would like to ask you, do you think there are some sectors, some businesses that should need AI integration more than others, if there are any?
Now, companies have massive amounts of data. And what AI does is it makes this analysis or extraction of information from data much more efficient, fast, and often real time, if done properly. Real time is still a tricky word in this business. If you look at the energy networks, they have massive amounts of information. And also you have new players coming in with smaller grids. So energy consumption is definitely a use case, I would say. And also the banking and financial sector and healthcare is definitely another fertile ground for using AI. And drug discovery is another field. Because what we know is that we have immense amounts of information. There's so many permutations and combinations about which medicine would work for what. And they are also trying to use AI for drug discovery. So in terms of fields, these are the ones that I've already experienced in one way or the other, that they are making big gains with AI.
What I would like to ask you next is how does AI adoption work in companies and what are their requirements? Because since we talk about why is it important, then let's talk about how does it work.
The first requirement is to have data. That's what's been shown up now. And then there are technical requirements, such as having the data in a form that can be put together, can be queried, can be explored. I think that if you have your business plan and you want to go to that direction, that's not the big problem. The big problem first is to know what you want to do with AI. So what we've been saying before, what Shalini has been saying before, you have to know what you want to achieve. You want to make predictions, you want to make classification, you want to automate, you want to, like, whatever. That must be very clear and seems easy, but it's not. Because whenever you want to do something using AI, you need to express your requirements in terms of what can you extract from your data with algorithms, any stuff, but that must be in the data. It cannot be injected by people's mind or semantics or common sense. That's what's really lacking there. So you need to have everything that you want to achieve, must be hidden in the data that you are using. And that's, I think, is the most important requirement. Another big one, which is on another level, it's an organizational level, is that whenever you want to apply and have benefit by an AI algorithm, you cannot limit your design of an AI system to a single department. Even if that's the department that will have benefit from the AI solution, normally, a good AI solution must be designed taking into account a lot of different departments that will have to put data or have to put knowledge or have to put their point of view in designing the system. In my experience, this is one of the most important requirements on the organizational level to be able to work together and have a very heterogeneous table of people designing this AI system so that you don't miss any of the key points that you want to put into the artificial intelligence.
Yeah, absolutely. You really hit the nail on the head about the communication and the organizational impact, because it's not just a technological solution, because there's a lot of change of mindset required. And first of all, what's very important is to set the right expectations. What can AI do for me at the moment? Because sometimes it can turn out to be some kind of a vanity project where we say it's going to solve everything. And that's because everybody's talking about AI, so it must solve all my problems. So that's a bad attitude to start with. So to have the right expectations, the right infrastructure, people, skills, and most importantly, data. So do I have enough data to make sense for this problem?
Since we talk about requirements, and there are a lot on many levels, and companies should be conscious of them, I would like to add, what can be the most significant barriers to AI adoption, but also efficiency, because at the end, what's important is AI efficiency.
Absolutely. And I really agree with what Shalini was saying about the expectation. This could be a big barrier because you start a project and then after a short time, people is already expecting whatever they have in their minds. And, you know, it's an advantage of AI that when you set the system works at some level, acceptable, but then the more you use the system, the more you go, you give feedback to the system, the more it should improve its results. So the only way to have a system to really to flourish and reach the best results is to use it, is to have it in the wild, because that's the only way that data, real data can come and then feedback can be given and the system can enhance its results. And another very key point is to understand the results. It seems simple for those working on AI to understand concepts such through which we deliver results, such as precision, recall, accuracy, but also lift. There are many, many words, many specific words that can be explained very easily. Well, not now here, but of course, it's a few hours are enough to understand, or a few days of full immersion on AI are enough. And that would bring an enormous benefit to the AI world, because in this way, people is really understanding what I mean when I say this works at 99%. What does it mean?
Yeah.
And then I already said before the requirements can turn into barriers,
yeah,
such as the problems of compliance, of privacy, so the need to access a lot of data that must be checked against all the other structure in the company that take care of all these legal issues, which are really important.
I like the way Marina said, I would like the models to be in the wild and not in an incubator somewhere. So being in the wild is being in production, being in operational environment. And to get there, there are a lot of issues. And one of the biggest issues is the data quality and accessibility. Everybody has this attitude that this data is mine. I won't give it away, even if it doesn't have privacy sensitive data. It might not have any sensitive data sometimes, but they're like, oh, why should I give this data to somebody else? One aspect is definitely privacy. So you have GDPR in Europe, you have the California Consumer Protection Act in the US, you have the HIPAA for healthcare in the US. So you have so many, it's not just a European thing. There are a lot of privacy compliance rules which say that if you collect your data for one particular purpose, you cannot use it for something else. So sometimes you can't, that data might be brilliant to start an AI project, but you cannot use it. And the other aspect is the data quality. So what Marina was saying is that it's very hard to get good quality data, data cleaning or getting it in a format or a shape where you can use it is not sexy work, you know. As always, barriers and solutions, they go hand in hand. So when I talk about some of the solutions might sound as barriers if you don't implement it. So.
What we talked about the some sort of education across all work departments lead me to the last question for our interview today, which is a bit of a projection on the future. And Marina, I would like to ask you, how will artificial intelligence change the future of business, in your opinion?
AI can change a lot. That they can, if the companies will start, and they will, I presume, to use AI in all processes, in optimizing a lot of their operations in every field. AI will take care of the day by day, and people will take care of what can be done differently in the future. Think that AI cannot be done unless you ask her to predict something, but there's always the human design behind this. And what about the small and medium enterprises? On the one hand, I believe that for those companies as well, that can make the difference. And I think that there are many cases where implementing AI system could have those companies to have to jump ahead. Of course, in order for this to happen, it's important that there is a very pervasive knowledge of AI. Also, probably you don't need, if you're a small, medium enterprise, you don't need to use such enormous and very expensive algorithms that need hundreds of cores in order to run and days. But you probably can have benefits just starting with some small, simple, very well-focused algorithm that can anyway relieve humans of a lot of day-by-day work, or have it done better or achieve better quality, whatever is the context in which we apply it. But the risk is that if the PMIs, the small medium enterprises, are left behind in this evolution, what could happen in the worst case is that they big company take the business, the space, the knowledge, the know-how, the very important solution that the small company have discovered. The big company using data can come to know this and make it their normal operating way, so that the small company can lose their business value and the reason why they are on the market.
We all hear about reports that say that by 2030, AI is going to create X trillion dollars in global economy, but where is this going to is something it's unknown, and there could be economies of scale here, because sometimes if you have massive amounts of data, the amount of hardware you need or the kind of algorithms that you need to run might give you a great competitive advantage, and how can we catch up with this divide? And small and medium enterprises don't have access to these resources, but they're nimble enough, they're able to change their course very quickly. So they could be the ones building critical pieces of this AI infrastructure. They could be the one developing innovative solutions that can plug into this massive technological stack, if you may. We should also be aware of the importance of data from the beginning, and get your infrastructure right, have iterative developments about your AI processes. And I think it sounds boring, but I think they should get together some standards and processes in building AI and data models and pipelines. I think it will grow quite organically from that.
Integrating AI in businesses is not that easy, but of course, AI can bring a great potential value to companies. So thank you for sharing with us your experiences, and thank you, Marina, for being with us. It was a pleasure. For our viewers, don't forget to follow us on our social media profiles on LinkedIn and Twitter, and to subscribe to our YouTube channel. You can find us at Clearbox AI pretty much everywhere. And you can find also on our social profiles so much more content about machine learning, MLOps, data-centric AI, etc., etc. So don't forget to follow us, and I hope to see you soon. Bye.
Bye.
Thank you very much. Bye-bye.